Welcome back to the book of Unwritten Tales. I'm your host, Lostwolfe. This is episode 17. And today's job is going to be to get everyone to this level here. Right. So, like I said previously, we know all the things that we need to know in order to get everyone where they need to be. Let's just look around real quickly.
Looks a little like my Aunt Ethel.
There are a couple of things that you can't actually deal with until you've looked at them, so.
Even at this depth, there are still roots, and it looks like they keep going down. Maybe I could reach them with Cap and Nate's help.
Right, let's get,
Cap and Nate, Wilbur
up.
Give me a boost up.
Why should I?
Then I might be able to reach the roots.
And then what?
Well, then I pull myself up.
So what good does that do me?
Well, maybe I'll find a way to get you out of here.
Huh. All right, then.
It worked!
I'll wait and celebrate later, when I'm out.
I don't really like how people treat Wilbur's shame. Anyway, so we can step on here. And we kind of learned what we already knew. This is a weight system. So what we need to do is we need to distribute the weight such that we can get both of them on the pedestals at the same time to get them up at the same time. Well, we're going to do it by degrees, but that's the basic idea. What?
Captain Nate, could you give me a boost up? Thanks.
And no, if you're seeing idiosyncrasies in the video, I'm not sure why they're there. That just seems like a problem with the split of the game. Anyway, so let's get Nate onto here. And let's get Wilbur onto here. Now, he's too heavy, and Wilbur's too light. But there's a little block over here.
That's quite a chunk of rock, but I might still be able to move it. It works! Together, the stone and I are heavy enough. Away with you!
I don't know why he does that. That stone's awfully useful. But anyway, now we have Nate on this level, and Wilbur was saying that he couldn't move this, he wasn't strong enough. So let's sort that out.
Let's see. That was it. The hatch is open.
Okay, and now with the hatch open, because the hatch is pretty small, we can get Wilbur into the chamber over here, and he can use the ladder. Let's get Wilbur onto here. And let's get Nate onto here. I don't think it's possible for you to lock yourself here, but I'd rather be careful and safe rather than sorry. Okay. And now we can go through here. And up.
The ladder leads up into the dark, and the shaft gets narrower up there. Hi, Ivor!
Wilbur!
I found a hidden ladder. It brought me here.
Brilliant! What's that glittering up there with you?
This! A crystal!
Oh, can you throw it down? I've got an idea what it might be used for.
I have to keep going. Having adventures, avoiding traps, revealing secrets.
I think I've underestimated you, my little friend.
So she says a good thing there. Soon she'll take it back. Anyway, up here on this ledge, it's very difficult to see, but there's a pedestal over there with a stone tablet on it.
That's a stone tablet. It bears the same symbols as the ones you see everywhere on the walls.
The only way to know that would have been to kind of hotspot click all the way around. So, we are on the middle level. Let's give our treasure to Ivo.
Look, Ivo, I found a stone tablet with symbols on it.
Really? Show me. I think that's just what I'm looking for. Thank you.
We make a good team.
Now, don't get overconfident.
Says something good and then takes it back immediately. Now, remember, Ivo said an interesting thing. She said that the temple is controlled through this mechanism here. Let's look at the stone tablet that we have.
The stone tablet has rows of symbols like the stone rings inscribed on it.
Right, and here we see that there are, and this is the way you know to read them downward, incidentally. There are three columns and four rows. And this makes it apparent that you're supposed to read them downward. Okay, so let's take a look at our friend, this magic set of blueprints. Now the great thing is that this will keep the tablet in the lower right hand corner for all the time that you're using it. So we've already got the snail head there, the thing that looks like a snail. We want the ant, I think, and then that, I believe, and that.
Sounded like something's happened again.
Okay, so what's happened is it's opened up these two lower pieces, and Nate can now look at this one over here.
Ah, the figure's mouth is opened. There's something like a switch inside.
Okay, I don't want to quite press that yet. What I do want to do, though, is I want to get Wolba down. Again, I am not sure that you can. I don't think it's possible for you to lock yourself, but I'd rather be safe than sorry. Oh, goodness. I keep forgetting you have to use the exits in order to get anywhere. There's, like, a tunnel thing here?
The passage is almost as small as the hatch over there by the ladder. I can't even see where it goes.
Let's head in there anyway.
Aha! So that's where this leads.
Is there another crystal there?
Yes!
Excellent! Well done!
Now, fortuitously, we don't have to do anything else, really, with Wolby here at this point. So we can just get him up to where he needs to be, which is the middle row. Or, shouldn't really call it the middle row, the level playing field here, where everyone else has got to end up congregating. So, Nate noticed the switch. Let's press it. and see what happens. And now we notice that there's water, and the water, as you can see there, is moving the platforms up and down and up and down. So it's now possible for us to get Nate to move around in this little spot here. So let's see what else we can do with our control panel. Okay, so let's do, I believe it's that, and like a bushy thing, which should be that, and then a planty thing. I don't think it's, maybe it's, no, it's not that. I lie. It's not that. It's not that. It's not that. It might be that. And then an actual leaf. So remember how, Nate was saying that the problem was that we couldn't turn the hatch? Well, we can now. Again, I keep forgetting that I have to actually go to the exit. Okay. So this closed the door. Now, the thing about this is that there, we've sort of seen that there's a space up here, and what's going to happen is a scary thing, but we need to do it. Okay, last little set of symbols. That looks sort of like that to me, like an ice cream cone, I guess, and a leaf. Ali. Oh, come on. I don't think it's that. Maybe it's this. Although that looks kind of wrong. And star. I'll skip the star. There we go. And there.
Cold. Wet.
Oh, good. Okay, that means it worked. So Nate's gonna float up here, and then we'll be able to get him to climb out. And now everyone's on the same level. Okay. Oh. Good grief. Oh, it looks like it's whenever they use an exit that the, it's going a little bit odd. Let's talk to everyone and see what they have to say.
Work before pleasure. Have you found a way out of here already?
No.
So what are you hanging around here for, then? Chop chop.
See? Not very nice. Anyway, so let's head on through the door here. And there's little separate bits here that we can see. There's a crystal, and there's a grimacing face, which we haven't looked at all.
Peculiar face it's pulling. The mouth's open wide. Looks like it should be fed with something. There's right. another face like that over there. Looks exactly the same as this one here.
Right. So, let's do this.
Aha.
And this.
Exactly the same as over there.
Okay, so, at this point we can try and, you know, see if we can gain entry.
Wow, that looks very promising. Only, nothing else is happening.
Right. What we need to do, of course, is get everyone in there at the same time. I just get them oriented so that I can quickly switch between them. Okay. I'll start here. Oh no. Well, where are you going? I thought I brought everyone here. Oh well, evidently not. Oh, we're gonna be weird and difficult, I see. Okay, well. There we go. And then Ivo.
Aha, uh-huh. We can move on at last.
The door only remains open when all three crystals are being touched. That means that only the person standing by the door can go through it.
So who's gonna go?
That is the question.
I'm so small that I can crawl through anywhere, and Caponate is so strong.
And Ivo is so sexy.
And how's that supposed to help?
No idea. I just thought I'd mention it.
Okay, so we're going to have to make a decision about who's going to go in, and we will do that in the next episode. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Lostwolfe. This has been my friend, Book Unwritten Tales, episode 17. I hope that you're enjoying it as much as I'm enjoying playing it for you. I shall see you all soon. Have a wonderful evening, and good night for now, folks.